want to start off by saying thank you guys so much. Really appreciate the opportunity. I want to say thank you to JM3 for showing so much love on stage. I want to say what an honor it is, like I've said it before, to be able to share a stage with Tony Robbins. And here's the crazy thing about me being here tonight, which we happened to do this last year, but me running and gunning, kicking ass and taking names. You tend to forget certain things. So when I was here last year, when I left, I said, man, you know what's crazy is my first performance in an arena was in this arena. And this was about, I would say, 2005. And it was called the Boo Bomb Concert that they have here in the Bay Area. And I was performing a record called Kulo. Which I think y'all might know the record. Esa jevita está enterita, tiene tremendo. Está tan linda, está tan rica y tiene tremendo. Chiquita, chiquita, pero que importa si tiene tremendo. Hazme favor y menea de chica, tiene tremendo. Well, then definitely the record worked out, let me tell you. Thank you guys for that. But here's the irony around that. My mother put me on to Tony Robbins. Next thing you know, Tony Robbins is handing me a Hollywood star. Next thing you know, we're on the same stage with Tony Robbins in San Jose. So I always tell you this story. You know why? Because it's the truth. And the only reason that I took this, I didn't take this opportunity. This opportunity was given to me, and I don't understand it or even believe it at this point, to be honest with you. Why? I look at it and I say, God damn. So with that said, I'm gonna start off with a couple of things, and I wanna start off with this word right now called instant gratification. And there's no way I would be on this stage right now if it wasn't for the fact that in 2005, we were here performing, working hard, grinding, fighting, struggling, sacrificing, and we still work hard, grind, struggle, and sacrifice. But to be on the same stage as somebody that, by default, taught me a whole lot, it's a true honor. But that doesn't come by instant gratification, folks, by the way. And I would say the new word now is everybody want to be an entrepreneur. Entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurial. I just call it being a hustler. Because that's my business. My business is I only got 6 seconds to get y'all hooked. So I gotta give you a good product. 6 seconds, folks, call them. Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I didn't even throw the Mississippi in there, by the way. I gotta get you hooked by that point. So the product's gotta be good. So my first time I seen an entrepreneur, entrepreneurship, or people being entrepreneurial, was this product in Miami in the 80s called cocaine. Okay? And I seen people take nothing, make it something. I seen people become filthy, filthy, filthy rich, didn't know what to do with it. I seen a lot of people lose their lives. I seen a lot of families destructed. I seen a city built on cocaine, which is called Miami. Don't listen to me, look it up, you ain't gotta Google it. Anything I tell you is the truth. And that's why New York is the Big Apple and I call Miami the Pineapple. Now what did I learn from this? What I learned from this was how to move. And those guys, the guys that survived, the guys that understood what it is to be an entrepreneur, was they knew how to protect what they had. They knew that not showing everybody what they got, okay, not showing everybody how they move is what allowed them to survive. I go back to the word instant gratification. We live in a world that we want to show everybody what we're doing. We live in a world of two words, and I'm all about, mind you, my whole life has been built off of remix and tweaks. I'm far from a genius. I'm far from a genius. I just happen to know how to get your shit and make it better. So when I look at what's going on in the world right now, you got two words that people are living by: followers and likes. Now let's think about this. Followers and likes. Where's this gonna take us, folks? And I guess we're gonna be followers and worry about if people like us. I think we should tweak that. We should make it leaders and unique. Thank you. So the only way I came up with this, why? Because of everything I seen growing up. And when I was young, I was about 5, 6 years old, I had already seen a couple things, and as a young mind, you absorb a lot, you see a lot. You analyze, as much as adults may think we analyze kids, man, they run circles around us. They run circles around us. So as a kid, I seen so many things that by 5, 6 years old, I made a decision. I said, man, if there's anything I want in life, it wasn't money. I wanted security, stability, and protection. That's all I wanted. Moved around too many times, no water too many times, eviction too many times, no electricity too many times. Young sister pregnant at the time. And this ain't about being a victim, it's about telling a story. And I'm here to motivate and inspire you guys so that you can get caught up, or don't get caught up, I'm saying. Don't get caught up with the bullshit that's going on right now. So how do you move forward on that? You move forward on that with this thing called ownership. What do we work hard for in life? Ownership. To be able to own what we do. And that's what my life and my family taught me. A grandmother that was a part of the, quote unquote revolution in Cuba, was one of the first four women to fight. Well, one of the first four women to fight with Castro in the mountains, they call it La Sierra Maestra. And imagine, she learned a lot from that man. As we see, whether we like or we don't like, you gotta tell a story for what it is. This is the only man that ever told the United States of America, fuck you, and he died naturally. Let's put that into play. She was next to this man. I'm not talking about Osama bin Laden, got his ass. Saddam Hussein, got him. Gaddafi, gone. It's a true story now. Castro died on his own. And he was only 90 miles away. So why am I telling you this? Because if you look at the history of what went on, whether it was the Bay of Pigs, whether it was the Russian Missile Crisis, the Cuban Russian Missile Crisis, that's what my grandmother was next to. So being next to him and figuring out that's not who she wanted to be next to, she found a way for us to get out. That was my aunt became a political prisoner because she started to help the other side, which was Batista. That's where my mother got out. They found a hustle through religion, which was Peter Pan. My mother went from Cuba to Indiana. Now that's what you call a culture shock. And I'm only telling y'all this story, and I say it all the time, because women and a woman made me a man at the end of the day. So when you have a grandmother that's next to somebody that, now whether we like or we don't like, strategically is moving. An aunt that moves for what she believes in, a mother that got displaced, and they gave me the chance to be here in the United States of America. And I was born here in 1981, right after the Mario boat lift, which my father brought boats over in. And my father, by the way, he won the lottery in Cuba. You know what the lottery in Cuba is? Freedom, partner. Freedom, that means leave whatever you got, it ain't yours, get the fuck out of here, gone. And what does that mean? I want all of us here to understand and appreciate, no matter what you guys think or don't think, and opinions you may form, who you vote for, you don't vote for, doesn't matter. You're the United States of America. You got freedom. And that's what they taught me. They taught me how to appreciate opportunity. They taught me how to appreciate freedom. They taught me how to appreciate liberty. They taught me how to create, one way or another, ownership in a way that I can own my own destiny, create my own destiny. And that's all we've ever done. And so when you hear me and I say I've taken my life from a negative to a positive, and you see the city that I come from, you see the kind of guys I grew up around, I'm far from a tough guy, I ain't a gangster, I ain't a thug, I ain't a killer, but goddamn it, I'm a hustler. So when I got the opportunity and had the escape through music, I said, man, we gotta take this to another level because I want people to know the story. I want them to understand the message. I want them to understand what this music comes from. Because you got your Van Goghs, your Leonardos, your Michelangelos, and they all painted an amazing picture. But that's all we do through music. I just painted you a picture. And sometimes it may be a picture of me in a club, sometimes it may be a picture of me in the streets, sometimes it may be a picture of somebody that I loved, I put it on a record. Sometimes it may be a picture of me around all the world, around the world. But every picture that I paint one way or another has a hidden message. And that's why I took on this new challenge. And that's why I said when we started this, thank you guys so much for the opportunity to be up here and be able to tell you the story. And I want to make sure that you guys, the same way that we've done in music, okay, is I want you to create your own lane. I want you to create your own world. I want you to live by your own metrics. Don't worry about followers and likes. Don't worry about what they say. Don't worry about people that tell you that you can't, don't, won't, impossible, you're crazy. The more they tell you that, use it as gasoline to the fire. Fuel yourself with it. Because I'm a prime example of it. First generation Cuban American, and as much as whether we want to get rid of immigrants in this country, I don't understand that because this country was built by immigrants. As much as we talk America and Americans, if technically we break this down, none of us are, but the Native Americans are. And I think we get lost a lot with what's going on in the world. So when I get a chance to hit this stage and tell you the story about everything that's going on, and I tell you about creating your own metrics and creating this ownership, is because we're in a business, we've been growing in a shrinking business. You know, the music business has been going down for a whole lot of years. It looks like it's gonna have a little bit of a rebound now. But I'm gonna tell you why they've been going down for a lot of years. Because they were thieves. They did the wrong business. They took people's art and they ran with it. They took people's lives and they ran with it. And they took people's careers and they ran with it. And they never really gave them what they earned. So therefore, karma's not a bitch, she's a whore. And came back and got them for everything. So I've sat back, I'm 18 years in the game, I've sat back and I've watched them from so many angles, and all I can do is learn. I don't got the right answers, but I can't tell you what I've learned. And I learned how to create my own lane. And when I say I mean we, I mean us, I mean I. There's no way I can't do this without a team. And Team Pitbull and the people that have been with me for, man, more than 15 years of my life, people that had the same goal, same vision, and understood that there was gonna be a lot of people that didn't believe in us. They still don't believe in us. I still wake up in the morning and tell me, you're crazy, that'll never work. Guess what that does? That motivates me. I say, I think we got a good record. Talk to you guys about ownership, create your own destiny, and create your own metrics. What I mean by that is, just because the billboard says you got a number one record, that don't mean shit. Let me tell you right now. Every other week, they're coming up with different metrics. Well, if you got this many views on YouTube, and you got this many Spotify, you got this much, put that all together, and it's a number one. Next week, oh, don't worry about YouTube, now it's all about just this, and then it's this, you put that together, and it's all a number one. It's like, damn, so now I gotta live my life on the fact that you don't know what you're talking about. So we learned a long time ago how not to do that, and I want y'all to do the same. I want y'all to believe in yourselves. I want you to believe in your gut. Believe it or not, your gut tells you a whole lot. It tells you a whole lot. And I got a good one for you guys. I don't know if you're gonna understand it, but either way, I'm gonna let it go tonight. And this is, you gotta think like an asshole. Not like this asshole, I'm talking about this asshole. And listen to your gut. Because guess what? If you don't listen to your gut, it doesn't matter. You're gonna shit on yourself. You understand me? Gotta be connected, folks. You gotta read the signs, you gotta read the play. So, with that said, us creating our own lane in the music business, and as you see, light skin, Cuban, blue eyes, got in the game. And I stick out like a sore thumb in my game, let me tell you. Learned a lot, always open for constructive criticism, always open for advice, and always open to help. And the biggest investments that we make, it's not in companies, it's not in corporations, it's not for that $1 billion exit. Well, goddamn, now they're talking about $1 trillion. Jesus, I don't know where else we're gonna go after this. But it's about investing in people. When you invest in people that you believe in, people that believe in you, people that believe in the same vision, the same goal, that's when you see things come to life, and guess what? It doesn't happen with instant gratification. Because on the streets, if anything we ever spoke about dope money, it's real simple. There was one line right after it. Dope money, it's real simple. What comes quick, leaves quicker. That's dope money. So for us, it's all about a slow but a for sure. And we have a saying in Spanish, para todos los latinos que están aquí esta noche. Is paso corto, vista larga, which is short steps, long vision. This is a marathon, not a sprint, folks. Enjoy this ride. Live life, don't let life live you. Don't get caught up in other people's bullshit at the end of the day. So, I was thinking on the plane, coming over, and I said, I wanted to talk about a couple of words that everybody lives for. Well, for one, I think a lot of us, okay, I always say it's never about the money, it's always about the journey, because there's no money I can make in this world and take with me when I'm gone. But I can have an amazing story. And I want you guys to think about that. Now, the only way you can have an amazing story, yeah, you make the money, I get that part. And mind you, make the money, don't let the money make you. That's a whole different story. Okay? So as you become, you know, one way or another succeed, create success and become successful, you get this money. Well, money somehow, some way, people think that once you got money, you're happy. Money buys happiness, right? Well, a friend of mine, I told him after I became Thank God I earned a little bit. I told him, you know, man, it's crazy. It's true what they say, money doesn't buy happiness. And you know what he turned to me and said? He said, no, you're wrong. Money does buy happiness. You just got to give it away. So as everybody that's here, that's focused and learning and wants to make themselves better, you get the money, then you look for that thing called happiness. Well, here's the beautiful thing about the word happy. It has a definition, but it can't be defined. Meaning you can look it up in the dictionary, read it, whatever it may tell you, but it can't be defined because you create your happy. You create your world. Whatever makes me happy may not make you happy. And whatever makes you happy may not make me happy. But that doesn't matter at the end of the day, as long as you create your world, you earned your world. And that's what I want you guys to understand by ownership. Don't worry about other people's metrics. Don't worry about what other people think. Create your own lane, you create your own world. Now from happy, you take it to normal. Because even when you make the money and you think that you're happy, you're worried about what everybody else thinks is normal. Oh, that's not normal to do that. Oh, it's not normal to do this. Let's go back to the dictionary. Normal has a definition, but it can't be defined. Okay? Your normal may be your normal. My normal is another normal. It's really that simple. Okay? When you understand these kind of things, you take it, you create your own world. So I take money to happy, happy to normal, normal to dance. Dance, dancing. Let's go back to the dictionary. As a definition, can't be defined. Because let me tell you something. Don't ever, how you doing? The beautiful thing about dancing is the music tells you what to do. You get me? Music tells you what to do. And in the world and in society in this day and age, I feel like we let people tell us what to do. Okay? And when I go back to ownership, create your own destiny, create your own metrics, your own lane, your own world. It's the same thing as dancing. See, I may dance like this, right? You may dance like this. You can hit him with merengue, you may dance like this. And all I'm going with it is, life is a dance. Dance it however you want to dance. Don't let anybody tell you how to dance. You are not. And the funny thing is, with all the dances that are out there, everybody got a name for a dance and how you got to do it and where you got to do it. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, whatever it may be. There's this one guy that just happened to turn around in an award show and hit you with one of these. Right? I don't know about you, but I don't know anybody that knew about the moonwalk before that. But guess what Michael Jackson did? Took a risk. Thought out the box, wherever he may have seen it, however it may have happened, and he took over the world on a dance that nobody did. And that's what made Michael Jackson. That was one of his signature moves. And that's what I'm trying to tell y'all. When you think out the box and you do something that nobody's looking at, of course people are gonna hate. That means you're doing the right thing. Of course people are gonna talk, that means you're doing the right thing. And mind you, for anybody here that's in business and that is growing and is looking to get to the next level, well guess what guys, that comes with another word called lawsuits. That means you're really doing the right thing. Okay? So for everybody here that wants to be a part of success, that wants to be successful, that wants to succeed, just know guys, and I've said this plenty of nights before, if you look at every word, succeed, success, successful, it starts with the word suck. Because the higher you get in that ladder, You're giving people access to suck in excess, my friends. That's how it works. That's how it works. And as you get higher in that ladder, and the more successful you get, you start to protect, create stability, and create security. So for everybody here tonight, I just want to let y'all know, it's real simple, folks. Believe in yourself. When people tell you don't do it, you go for it. The biggest risk you take is not taking one. Okay? And I'm only telling you this, why? Because every day I wake up in the morning, I get knocked out. I fall on the floor and I get right back up. One way or another, there's always something getting shot at me, and I don't want you guys to think that I'm not the one that's gonna sit up here and tell you, oh man, my life's amazing, I do this, I do this, I do that. No, you know what, I'm very blessed to live a very blessed life, okay? But it's not making it, and thank God for that. It's not about making it, man. It's about maintaining it. And once you find a way to maintain it and you feel like you got something that's worth holding on to, my friends, enjoy it. And let me tell you something. I was on tour with Kesha, and Kesha was not only a part of one of my biggest records and helped us out with that around the world, which was Timber, but she said something one time when I was walking across on tour, and she said to me, hey, I come back, I said, what? She said, Pete, let me tell you something. Don't ever grow up as a trap. I was like, okay, that was great, I appreciate it. But it was genius. Guys, with that said, is this, be successful, have success, succeed, make the money, build the companies, do whatever you want in life, but don't ever forget what it is to have fun, what it is to enjoy, what it is to be happy. So to be here in San Jose, man, 13 years later, from performing Culo on this stage, to being on the same stage with Tony Robbins, to being able to talk to you guys about our story and hopefully one way or another motivate and inspire, and you see this comes from a real place. It's a true honor, guys, and I appreciate it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get back to the party now. And this next record is all about getting rid of all the negative things in life. We call it un despojo. Get rid of it. And all about welcoming all the positive things in life. So whether you speak Spanish, English, Portuguese, Chinese, doesn't matter, because you speak the universal language that's called music here tonight. So my amigo, vamos a la fiesta. Dale.